Hello my dear students, I hope you all are doing well with the online learning. Today this video is on common errors due to Indianism, that is where do we make mistake while speaking English. And we all know that in English, the British English is the standard one which we need to learn. In India we usually study and we follow it. But most of the time, we Indians are influenced by our own language. We create our own English most of the time. And since English is not a native language, it is not easy for us to attain the level of accuracy and comfort that comes with the luxury of using a mother tongue. In fact, there are large number of expressions, words, phrases and other linguistic structures commonly employed by the Indian speakers and writers of English. And the most of the times, since a large number of people talk or write in a particular way, it gains currency over the years and is never noticed for it being anomalous to standard English usage. However, when it comes to interacting with native speakers, such errors not only confuse the native users of English but also bring into question our credibility as proficient users of English. So in this video, we are going to understand the few differences between the words where we most of the time misplace it in the sentences. So the first one is get versus gets. We usually feel it is similar, it won't make much difference, right? Because both words are same, get and gets. Only the difference is S, that is what we consider. And that is what is the common errors due to Indianism. So a very common mistake made by the Indians which sees them adding the word S to words unnecessarily. Example, unless you get your act right, do you feel the sentence is proper? This is wrong. Unless the words you is replaced by he and your is replaced by his, better yet your cab drop the letter S from gets. So this is the main difference. Then moving on to the next is dear versus there. More often than not, these words are misused. Dear refers to people, whereas there is used to refer the place. So most of the time when you write down the notes also, you make lots of difference. You feel again it is the same. Why? Because it's a sounding same. Then example, I have been there, they came with their goods. This is the right one. The next one is blunder versus mistake. These two words basically mean the same thing and can never be used in a sentence at the same time. Example, you have made a blunder mistake. See, in a sentence you can find both blunder also is the same and mistake also is the same. When you are scolding anyone or when you are telling someone about their mistake, reminding them, you cannot say you have made a blunder mistake because both the words are again same. This is wrong because the sentence actually means you have made a mistake. It can either be you have made a mistake or you have made a blunder. Then the next word is more versus better. At no point should they be used together in a sentence again. This could never have turned out to be more better. See, when you read the sentence, you feel it's really correct one. This could never have turned out to be more better. But remember, again, the more and again the better is having a similar meaning. The word better in itself implies superiority, hence the use of the word more in the sentence is seen as being unnecessary, right? Because better is actually conveying you exactly what it is trying to. So more is completely unnecessary here. So it is a kind of redundancy again. I hope you all remember the redundancy video, right? Then the next is does versus do. Does is used in singular form while do indicates the plural nature of the subject. Example, why does he bother you a lot? Then why do they bother you a lot? So here in both the sentences, the first sentence is singular, that is why they have used does, and the second one you have used do because of the plural. Which versus that. Now, one of the most popular mistakes that cut across all nationalities, that should be used as a restrictive pronoun, while which should be used as a relative pronoun to imply the available options in a nutshell, which defines and that limits. Example, I never watch movies that are not HD. This means that you limit yourself to HD movies. I hope you are clear with the sentence and the meaning, right? The next is, I only watch HD movies which are available on DVD. It means that you can watch HD movies available on DVD and do not have to download them. Okay. Then, the next is place versus second place. This is very common spelling mistake. Place refers to a certain location or a position, you all know that. Whereas place is some type of a fish, though it sounds same but the spelling is again different. Example, he took the first place. Who needs a place? That's about the fish. Then, next is accept versus except. Again, it sounds same, accept versus except, right? When spoken, these words sound almost the same and can be confusing to non-natives. Accept means to agree, to take something that is being offered, while accept means with the exclusion of something. Example, kindly accept this as a token of appreciation. That is, you have to agree, accept it. The book is new, accept the cover. That is the exclusion. Then is the it's and it's. See here, the difference is only between the comma now, right? So it's is used to show possession, while it is the short version of it is. Example, it's broken. The vehicle broke its windscreen. So this is again a difference you have to understand, that is separation of s from it. May versus might. May is normally used to imply a possibility, while might refers to uncertainty. Example, two shots may get you drunk. It might rain today. So this is the sentences where you can use may versus might. I'm telling it so very slowly so that you can actually read the slide also, and you can read the sentence by yourself and understand it. Then the next one is fewer versus less. Again, the meaning is similar. Fewer is mostly used on items that can be counted, while less is used for hypothetical quantities. Example, today the market has fewer people. Okay, and last year the company was less successful. Then, since versus because. Since refers to time, while because is used to refer casuality. Since I started drinking, I've lost around 10 cell phones. Because I'm highly intoxicated, I'll not drive. So try to understand between both the sentences and the difference between when you have to use since and when you have to use because. So again, it's the same one. Okay, so these are the common errors. So these are the common words usually we use in our day-to-day life and we make mistakes. So I hope you all won't repeat it now onwards, and we all will improve your standard English and you follow all the rules. And I hope you all are clear with the common errors due to Indianism also. So see you all soon for the next video with a new topic. Thank you. Till then, have a nice day.